हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर साइंस क्लास। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द सैम्पल पेपर एंड टुडे आल्सो वी विल कंटिन्यू विद दैट। एंड टिल येस्टरडे वी हैड कंप्लीटेड विद द क्वेश्चन 45 एंड टुडे we will start to understand the question number 46. Now let us see. So the refractive index of flint glass is 1.65 and that for alcohol is 1.36 with respect to air. What is the refractive index of the flint glass with respect to alcohol? So here the refractive index of the flint glass is given and that is 1.65. And that for alcohol is also given and that is 1.36 with respect to air. So the refractive index of flint glass with respect to alcohol, this will be equals to, how can we find it? It will be equal to refractive index of flint glass upon refractive index of alcohol. Okay. So here it is given the refractive index of flint glass with respect to alcohol we find out. So this will be equals to refractive index of glass upon refractive index of alcohol. Of glass upon refractive index of alcohol. Now this will be equals to what? So refractive index of glass, it will be equals to 1.65 divided by refractive index of alcohol is given, that is 1.36, and it will be equals to 1.21. So the refractive index of the flint glass with respect to alcohol, it will come out as 1.21. Okay, this is how we will find the refractive index of the glass with respect to alcohol. So here the correct option, it will be second, that is 1.21. Now let us move on and see the next one. Here in question number 47, the above lens, it has a focal length of 10 centimeter. The object of height 2 millimeter is placed at a distance of 5 centimeter from the pole. Find the height of the image. So here the above lens has given, it is having a focal length of 10 centimeter students, and the height of the object is given, that is 2 millimeter. So let us see what are the things which is given here. First of all, the focus which is given, it is what? It is 10 centimeter, and since here it is talking about the convex lens, thus the focal length will be taken in positive. Okay, so for convex lens focal length will be positive. So here f is equals to plus 10 centimeter, and the other thing which is given here is the height. So height of the object which is represented by h1, it will be equals to 2 millimeter, and when we convert it into centimeter, it will be 0.2 centimeter. So height, focal length is equals to plus 10 centimeter and height is equals to 0.2 centimeter. Now what is the distance of the object from the pole? So the distance of the object from the pole, u is equals to, obviously u is always minus, always negative, so minus 5 centimeter. So here we are knowing the value of a u and f, with the help of which we will be able to find the image distance. And the thing that we have to find is the height of the image. So height of the image, to find out the height of the image, we must know the distance of the image, that is V. So if we apply that of the lens formula, so this will be equals to 1 by F is equals to 1 by V minus 1 by U. 1 by F is given, that is 1 by 10 is equals to 1 by V, that we have to find it, minus 1 by 5. It will be equal to minus 5. Now what will happen when this 1 by V goes to the other direction? It will form 1 by V is equals to 1 by 10 minus 1 by 5. Ultimately, when we will take the LCM, it will give the value here, that is V is equals to minus 10 centimeter. So the image distance that we got here, it is what? It is minus 10 centimeter. Okay. Now, if we will take the magnification here, so we know that B by U is equals to H2 upon H1. This is what, this is how we can find the height of the image. So we are knowing the value of the V is minus 10 upon value of U is equals to minus 5. This will be equals to H2 that we have to find out, and H1 is given, and that is 0.2. This minus will cancel each other. It will become 2. So H2 will be equal to 0.2 into 2 is equals to 0.4 centimeter, or 0.4 centimeter we can say, or we can say 4 millimeter. So answer, it will be C only, students. So height of the image, it will be equals to 4 millimeter, 0.4 centimeter or 4 millimeter. Moving on, and let us see the next question. Here, a cable manufacturing unit tested few elements on the basis of their physical properties. So here some of the properties has been given of the cable which is manufactured and which is used for the testing purpose. So the property which is given here, it is malleable, it is ductile, electrical conductivity is there, and melting point is there. Now see here, these are the different cables, students, which is having the different properties, and we have to see that which of the element were recorded for usage by the company. Now let us see. So in case of malleability, the first one, yes, it is malleable, and the second one is not malleable, Y is also not malleable, and Z is malleable. So the first one is that is following the property, physical property, W and Z. Second one is ductility or ductile. So W, it is ductile also. X is not a ductile. There is no ductility. Y, no ductility. And Z, it is also having no ductility. Electrical conductivity. So electrical conductivity in case of a W, yes. In case of a X, again, yes, the electrical conductivity is there. Y, electrical conductivity is high, electrical conductivity is there. And Z, there is no such electrical conductivity is there. Melting point is quite high in case of a W. While in case of X, the melting point is low. Here also in Y, it is low. And Z, the melting point is high. So which of the above element will be discarded for uses by the country, by that of the company, sorry. So obviously, Y, Z, X, Y, Z is not following the properties of the metal. Only W is having all the properties of the metal, which will include the malleability, which will include the ductility, electrical conductivity, and melting point. So see here, it will be the B which will be not used, because X, Y, and Z, it is including all the three, which is not following the properties of the physical properties of the metal. So obviously, this it is the B only, X, Y, Z, which were the discarded for uses by the company. While X is what? It is following all the properties. So X, Y, and Z is that which is not following the different physical properties of the element. Now let us see the another section, and that is section C. Now see here, in case of a section C, here some of the cases are given, and there are 12 questions in each section. In this section 12 are there questions, and we have to attempt any 10. Now the first one is the salt story. Now let us see what is the case. From the New Indian Express, 9th March 2021, the salt pan in Marakkanam, a port town about 120 km from Chennai, are the third largest producer of salt in Tamil Nadu. Separation of salt from water is a laborious process, and the salt obtained is used as a raw material for manufacture of a various sodium compound. One such compound is sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is used in baking as an antacid and in soda acid fire extinguisher. The table shown shows the mass of a various compound obtained when 1 liter of a seawater is evaporated. So when 1 liter of a compound is obtained from that of the sea water, the compounds, the different compounds and its mass is given here. So sodium chloride is obtained, its mass is quite high, and it is about 26 gram of a sodium chloride is obtained. Second one, magnesium chloride is also obtained along with it. And magnesium chloride, mass of the magnesium chloride is 8 gram. Then magnesium sulfate, MgSO4, whose mass is given as a 6 gram. Then calcium sulfate is also given, and calcium sulfate mass is given as a 2 gram. Then calcium carbonate is also obtained from it, and calcium carbonate is about 1 gram. So total amount of a salt which is obtained from the different from that of the sea water, so that is 45, which will include all these different compound and its composition, its mass. This is that. Now see what are the different questions that can be asked from this paragraph. So here, which compound in a table react with acid to release carbon dioxide? Now the compound which is given here, out of this, which will going to react with the acid to release carbon dioxide? Obviously, if NaCl, suppose NaCl react with that of HCl, first of all, it is not possible. If it will react also, because it is salt plus acid, so it will get the acid and base, so there is no formation of a carbon dioxide. In case of a calcium sulfate also, there is no such formation. In case of a calcium carbonate, we know that the calcium carbonate, it react with the acid to produce carbon dioxide. So this CaCO3, when react with the HCl, then there is a formation of a CaCl2 plus CO2 plus H2O. So It is the calcium carbonate when react with the acid produces carbon dioxide. Okay, so answer it will be calcium carbonate. How many gram of magnesium sulfate are present in 135 gram of a solid left by evaporation of a sea water? So here magnesium sulfate, we have to find the grams or the mass of a magnesium sulfate which is present in 135 gram of a solid left of the sea water. So basically 135 gram of a solid is left behind here. So the number of a grams present in that of a magnesium sulfate, which is present in 135 gram of a solid left by evaporation of sea water, this will be equals to 18 gram. Now see here, if in case of the total salt obtained is 45, and out of that the magnesium sulfate is 6. So in case of a 135, the magnesium sulfate, it will be 18 gram. Okay, it will be 18 gram. Now see here, what is a saturated solution of a sodium chloride called? So the saturated solution of a sodium chloride, we use an another term for it, and that is brine. So here answer it will be brine, because brine, whenever we use the term brine solution, brine solution means what? We are talking about the saturated solution of the sodium chloride. Okay. Now, what is the pH of the acid which is used in the formation of a common salt? So, pH, if we talk about the pH which is used in the formation of a common salt, so it is again between 1 to 3. Okay. Why? Because in the formation of a common salt, the acid which is used is hydrochloric acid. You know that the strong base and strong acid react together to form sodium chloride. This is the laboratory preparation of the sodium chloride. So NaOH reacts with that of HCl to form NaCl. So this is what, this is that strong acid, and obviously the pH of this acid is quite high, so which is used in the formation of a common salt. So answer it will be A, that is the pH will be in between to that of 1 to 3. Now the figure shown below represent an activity to prove the requirement for photosynthesis, and during this activity two healthy potted plants were kept in the dark for 72 hours. After 72 hours, KOH is kept in the watch glass in setup X and not in setup Y. Both performed when one leaf from each of the two plants, X and Y. So here we have taken the two healthy potted plants and it is kept in dark for 72 hours. And afterward, KOH is kept in a watch glass in setup X, while in setup Y, there is no KOH is present in it. And this, it will be, then we have taken the one leaf from each and performed the experiment. Now the experiment setup, which is used to prove essentially of which of the following requirement of photosynthesis. Basically, chlorophyll, oxygen, carbon dioxide and sunlight. All these are there. So the experimental setup which is used to prove essentially of the following requirement of photosynthesis. The first thing, it is carbon dioxide. You know that potassium hydroxide used to absorb the excess amount of a carbon dioxide. So this experiment is actually it is there to explain that carbon dioxide is essential for the process of photosynthesis. Because when we have taken the potassium hydroxide used to absorb the carbon dioxide. So here, answer, it will be carbon dioxide. What is the function of KOH? The function of KOH is to absorb carbon dioxide. Yes. So again, the next one is also carbon dioxide. Which of the following statement shows the correct result of iodine test performed on the leaf from the plant X and Y? Blue-black color would be obtained on the leaf of plant X and no change in color on leaf of plant Y. Blue-black color would be obtained on a leaf of a plant Y and no change in a color on leaf of a plant X. Red color would be obtained on a leaf of a plant X and brown color on the leaf of a plant Y. Red color would be obtained on a leaf plant Y and brown color on the leaf plant X. So the first one will not going to show the blue-black color because the carbon dioxide is not present, so photosynthesis will not happen. But in the second one, blue-black color will be there. So obviously the answer will be the first one. The second one, in which blue-black color would be obtained on the leaf of the plant Y, yes, but no change in that of the X, because carbon dioxide is not present in X, so ultimately it will not going to change its color to blue-black, while X will not going to show any change in color. Which of the following steps can be followed for making the apparatus airtight? Placing the plant on glass plate, using a suction pump, applying Vaseline to seal the bottom of the jar, creating vacuum. So here, what are the method by which we can make the apparatus more airtight? And here, the first one, placing it the plate on a glass plate, and then third one also, in which when we can apply the Vaseline to seal the bottom of the jar. So C will be the correct option. Now see here, Noor, a young student, was trying to demonstrate some properties of light in her science project work, and she kept X inside the box with the help of a laser pointer made light ray from the hole of one side of the box. She had a small butter paper screen to see the spot of light being cast as they emerged. Okay. So, what could be the X which she placed inside the box to make the ray behave as shown? A converging lens, a parallel side glass block, a plane mirror, a triangular prism. Obviously, it will be a parallel side glass block. Because of that, the rays which is passing through it behaves like that it is passing straight. Okay, so X is what? It is a glass slab only. In between you will see that there is a refraction has occurred, and ray 2 which is coming out again, and that is an emergent ray. So answer, it will be a parallel side glass block will be the answer. She measured the angle of incidence for both the rays on the left side of the box to be 48.6. She knew that the refractive index of the material X inside the box was 1.5. What will be the approximate value of angle of refraction? So, angle of refraction we can find out by sin I upon sin R, and refractive index is given 1.5. So the value that we will give, that we will get here, it will be 30 degree. So answer, it will be 30 degree, student. Okay, so by knowing the refractive index and degree, we can get the value of the other one, and that will be 30 degree. Here the sine 48.6 value is already given, and the answer will be 30 degree.